Shout out from each one of you for all the participants. Can we have a big round of applause for all the participants? Praveen, can we go for the next one? I'll just tell you how we go about. Each one of you are going to walk up the ramp from this end, come to this point, and then step down from the other end. And we are going to tell you the names that's going to appear. And Praveen, can we go for the next one? And with me, I have District Governor Rashmi and myself, Dr. Chetan from 317A, and the next one. So this will be the order. If Sunaina walks first, Gloria and Trilok Chand will be the next to follow. So you will start from this end, and then you come up. To just make things easier, we will ask our expert to first walk, and Rashmi will... Destiny is not created by the shoes that you wear. Destiny is not created by the shoes that you wear, but by the steps we take. So you're going to take the steps forward to make it happen. Neil Armstrong, the first man to land in moon, made a statement that one small step for mankind, a giant leap for mankind. But I want to rephrase, one small step for lions, a leap for leadership. So friends, you're going to put up your right foot forward and make it happen. Can we have a round of applause before we go on? And Rashmi, please take over.
Kyunki kya karu, meri aadat hai muskurane ki. Dear lions, use your smile to change the world. Don't let the world change your smile, because nothing shakes the smiling heart. Friends, उम्र बढ़ने से मुस्कुराहट नहीं रुकती, लेकिन मुस्कुराहट रुकने से उम्र जरूर जल्दी बढ़ जाती है. सो ऑल द स्मार्ट डैशिंग लायन लीडर्स कीप स्माइलिंग थ्रूआउट द ऑनर वॉक एंड कीप चीयरिंग लायंस. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट.
या प्रवीण, प्लीज गो ऑन. वी स्टेप डाउन सो दैट द होल डायस इज फॉर यू. I think you are getting confused. You will get a partner only in this particular assignment and nowhere else.
Are you going to give us a partner?
Next time. So friends, what you have to do is very simple. When Bhaskar walks up, Pramod Singhi and Ravi Manuja will be ready on this stage. Is that clear? Is it clear now? Please. us. The laptop man who serves and gives laptops.
Thank you.
I'll tell you very simple. Fashion show ramp walk is very simple. समझे आपका फोन गायब हो गया, आप वॉक करना है, मेरा फोन आप चोरी किया है, आप चोरी किया है, इतना देखने का बस, ज्यादा कुछ नहीं है. करेगा ना आप लोग? कैन वी हैव ए राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर द मैन हु मेड ऑल यूर अकोमोडेशन पॉसिबल, लायन अमरनाथ. कैन वी हैव द म्यूजिक ऑन? You know something very special about your pose, please. Falls on Assam and then it comes down the country. Our son is the vice captain of the Belgium cricket team. And she comes from Mumbai. Please put your hands together for Jyoti Mehta. Until you raise the board, please raise the board. Yeah. Now we have the next gentleman who deserves all the applause. Together for line JP. JP, you have to wait for the music. So can we have a round of applause for the challenge. Can somebody pronounce the first name other than Tamil Nadu people? Other than Tamil Nadu people? Anybody from Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, Indore, Rajasthan, Guwahati? Bataiye kya hai? You need to share. Can you have the music down? Now, in pronouncing names.
It is Ari Organ. Ari Organ.
See, friends, the meaning of that name is so charming. Everybody will look beautiful, but his name means he is beautiful and brainy. Put your hands together for Ari Organ. Everybody become Praveen is one. Good question. Okay, the next ones. Gupta, the district governor from Indore. Again, somebody showed great project. So friends, put your hands together for Dr. Suchitra Sudhir. Walk up on the dais. Please come forward. Put your hands together. And Dr. Sudhir. Thank you.
possible. The team of Lions of member of C2D 320D, please come on stage. Do you think we must celebrate this moment? Yeah. How about celebrating this moment with the help of tea and coffee? Yeah. Great guy. Wait. Let me finish my instruction. Very, very important. From here, we'll move out. The tea and coffee is laid out. Once the tea and coffee is there for 15 minutes, after that, all of us will go for a group photo. We'll go for a group photograph, okay? You know why we have doing group photo now? Because we are running before time. And running before time is a good problem to have, right? So all of us are going to have a tea, coffee, then we go for a group photo, and then we come back here for the next exciting session on storycation by Deepa Kiran, right? Superb.
Telling, she loves connecting with children and adults. She trains teachers on story art-based learning. In her performances, training and talks, she waves in multicultural, multilingual musical elements to create an inviting experience. Focusing on development of English language, empathy, resilience, and critical thinking in multicultural, multilingual classrooms, she has reached over 75,000 educators across the world. Let us invite Deepa Kiran. Let's give us a big round of applause to Deepa. Deepa, over to you. Floor.
Who are willing to help anyone who does not know how to switch off a mobile phone? Please switch off your mobile phone.
Thank you very much for that, and thank you, Mr. Krishna Reddy, for the very warm welcome. I'm delighted and honored to be here with all of you. And like we were discussing, the energies are beautiful. I can sense it, and I'm really excited to be with such wonderful, accomplished individuals who are contributing so much to the society. I know this is a beginning of a wonderful learning journey for me, so I'm really honestly delighted and honored to be with all of you, spend a little time in this gathering from across the country. My name is Deepa Kiran, and I tell stories for a living. Yeah, that's what I do. I get onto stages and I narrate stories. That's my profession. And I've often heard, kahani to hum bhi sunate hain. Yeah, which is true. All of us are storytellers, and I'm sure there are many fantastic storytellers here. So I'm hoping today to share in a manner that's both interactive and experiential what I have learned over the last 20 years. It was in 2000 that I finished my master's in English literature, and many of my classmates had already done a B.Ed. or even an M.Ed. And I said, if there's one thing I will never do, that's teaching. And of course, the first job I got was, yes. So I taught in Kendra Vidyalaya, contractual appointment. There was the 11th and 12th class English teacher who was away on maternity leave. And then I promise I'm not exaggerating, I ended up teaching in many other Kendra Vidyalayas for the very same reason. The 11th and 12th class English teacher was on maternity leave. So I taught in contractual appointments, filling up for so many babies to be born. I taught across the country. I grew up in 10 cities in India. I've traveled, except beyond Assam, I've traveled to all the states of India. So I really do not know what my identity is. In fact, in class 2, when I was asked by my teacher, what's your mother tongue? I'd never heard that word, mother tongue. And my origin is Tamil Nadu. My mother is from a community that migrated from Tamil Nadu to Kerala, but her parents grew up in Bengal, so she was born there. So I've heard my mother speak Bengali with her sisters, and I calculated the only exclusive language that my mother speaks is Bengali. So I said, Bengali. And the teacher happened to be a Bengali, and she said, hey, aapni Bangla, and she started in Bengali. So it's a running joke in a family that I don't even know what's my mother tongue. But on the other side, I can speak English, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu. I follow Malayalam, Bengali, Punjabi. This is the upside of, you know, being a confused Indian who's lived all over. So I feel very excited in places like this. That's why I shared that small bit of story. As we start today, two things that I hope to address for all of us. And I see every session, every interaction of mine as an opportunity for all of us to spend that little time delving deeper and becoming more conscious and aware of our knowledge about storytelling and its possibilities. I say conscious and aware because I know that all of us value storytelling, and all of us use storytelling in different ways. So these sessions just bring up the knowledge at a very conscious level, discussing about it, reflecting on it, right? So storytelling in terms of one, the art of storytelling itself, and two, its possibilities in communication. And that's why it's called storycation. The work I do, I call it storycation, storytelling in communication. Yeah? So with that, I welcome you all to a small story. Would you like to listen? Yes? Okay, super. Come, listen, everybody. Just for you, I have a story. Come, listen, everybody. Just for you, I have a story. Come. So this is a story of a little boy. It was Diwali time. The next day was Diwali, and the boy turned to his mother and said, "Mama, new dress for me." And she said, "Sorry, beta. I do not have time to buy you a new dress." "No new dress?" "No, I didn't say that. You can go to the market and buy yourself a new dress." "What? I'm such a small boy." "It's very simple. Here, take this 100 rupees. The mother put a 100 rupee note in his pocket and she said, "Go to the market. Whatever the shopkeeper says, just quote half the price, okay?" "Okay, mama." And so he went to the market very quickly, feeling very excited that by himself he is going to shop. Lifting up his shirt collar, he went right up to the shop. It was early morning, the shopkeeper was just pulling up the shutter and he said, "This early in the morning, customer?" He looked for the parents, he saw the boy was alone.
"I've come alone, uncle, I want a shirt."
"Achcha, all right." So the shopkeeper called him inside. The shopkeeper showed him the striped and the floral and the checked and the pink and the dotted and everything. And the boy said, "I want the plain white shirt, uncle." "Take it. Only for you, 100 rupees.
50!
"Huh?" He was quite surprised. "Little boy has come alone and has the guts to bargain with me also, huh?" He said, "All right. Little boy, just for you, 80.
40!
"Huh? Doesn't work like that. All right. 60.
30.
"What to do with this boy? 50 final price, nothing below this for you, okay?"
"25, uncle."
"Who will sell a shirt for 25 rupees? Take it for free."
"I want two shirts, uncle."
And so he went back home with 100 rupees in his pocket and two shirts which he gave to his mama. That's the story of the boy who bought his shirt. Anything that's coming to anyone's mind after hearing this story, your mind or your heart, whatever, any feelings, any thoughts on hearing this story? You could use the mic, sir.
I think it's not the story itself that's very interesting. It's perhaps not the story itself that's very interesting. It's perhaps a story that's known to everybody, but the way the story is told, the emotion that's put into the voice, the modulation, the body language, that makes it a real story.
Okay, right. The dramatization of the story was interesting. Okay, right. Thank you. Anyone else? Any other thoughts? The theme involved in the story. Okay. Would you like to elaborate a little? How the little boy has taken his mother's advice so seriously. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Respect. Mother, to the child, cannot hear the communication by the mother to the child is, she knows the child is not matured enough any other language and bargaining technique. But she failed to communicate to his child. Whatever is told, you ask half. When it comes down, again half, and last bit of story giving free by the shop owner. Is only to make fun of the story or fun of the communication. So, what is to be learned from here is whenever one, through a story, we want to communicate something to the people, it should be clear so that the recipient level we have to come down to communicate, but at the same time, it should have a rationality of a communication. So, the story doesn't take to the logical end by the owner giving two shirts. It's just a mystery.
Yes, that's communication. Very true, sir. Anyone else would like to share anything? Yeah?
Yes. Sense in innocence.
Sense in innocence. Okay. That's a nice way of putting it.
Very, very interesting.
Okay. Yeah, lovely. So I am really grateful for your inputs, because everything is valid, it's true. This story is about senses, innocence, it's about communication, it is about visualization. Storytelling itself is about visualization. And that really is one of the strongest potentials of storytelling. I'm tempted to share things that I did not plan, but I'm going with the flow because it's coming to me. So I didn't plan to talk about this episode, which is, once I was doing a workshop where I wanted to show a video, you know, and there were some technical glitches. I could not play the video in that particular batch. I had played it in the other batches. So finally, I described the entire video. And I found that it was even more effective than actually showing them the video, because each of them had now, you know, put that effort in focusing, concentrating, receiving it auditorily, and then visualizing it themselves, you know. So the potential was so much higher because I didn't have the video to share. It was a very interesting observation for me. And this is something that I've observed working with children also, you know. What I say is that watching a very good video, no harm. I'm not against videos. I just made a documentary film and came back. I appreciate that medium. But watching a very good video would be like drinking a nice cup of tea. And listening to an oral story is like coming together, gathering, picking up the firewood, getting a big pot, pouring the hot water, you know, the tea, everybody sitting together, making the tea, preparing it and drinking it. Yeah, it's that much more deep and meaningful and memorable. I use the word memorable because there were some of you know who were saying that it brought memories of your past. So storytelling offers us space for recall. It offers us space for visualization, for creativity. And again, one quick story before we move to an activity from you. Yeah. So here's a quick story from me. This is one of my favorite stories. I was 10 years old and I used to live in Bangalore. That time I was studying, it was summer season, and we went for swimming classes in the municipality pool. I'd never ever done anything to do with water except the beach, hang my feet around. So I was very excited. I went with my classmates. 3 o'clock was the time for the women's batch. So all the girls, their mothers and I, we would go every day, and the lady coach would teach Nitya, Radhika, Mohita, everybody. And I would keep like, ma'am. She just didn't bother about me. After a week, I realized that Nitya, Radhika, Mohita's, their mothers used to sit on the side and watch on the steps. They would watch. So the lady coach was focusing on them. So I came back home and I told my parents, Amma has to come, Appa, because that lady coach, she is teaching only those girls whose mothers are sitting there. And both my parents very clearly, no way. So I felt like the most unloved, abandoned 10-year-old in the world. The next day, my father came home with a book. So my father, from when I was very young, he would take me to libraries, bookstores, read a lot of books, tell me a lot of stories. And his idea of gift is books. So he came home with a book, which was a Russian translation into English with photographs and pictures, and it was called Learn How to Swim. Okay, so it was so basic, like it even taught you how to walk into the swimming pool, you know, like hold both the sides of the steel ladder, put one foot after the other, don't let, literally like that. Okay, starting from there, how to get in, how to hold, how to try and float, how to slowly float away, then how to, you know, move your hands. So instructions to the T. I would read the book, go, practice, read, practice. This went on for a few weeks. Until one day when somebody shouted at me, like, can't you hear, madam is calling you. And madam was looking at me very angry. Madam, you know, lady coach. Yeah. She was looking at me full angry and she was whistling and she was saying something and there was water in my ears. Lot of sound, children, I couldn't follow. Then the girl said, madam is saying that so many times she has told, swimmers should go near the deep end. This place is only for learners. She's telling you to go to the deep end. Oh, I'm swimmer. And very proudly I swam across to the deep end that day. I still have that book with me. And I've shown it to my sons also. I taught my sons swimming and I showed them the book as well. I share this story okay? Once again, I'll leave my reason and I'll just ask you, what does it mean to you or what do you feel when you hear this story?
Practice.
Okay. Learn on your own. Self-confidence, motivation. Positive expectations. Take every situation as a challenge to overcome. Somebody said something behind about overcome and fear. Sorry. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Okay. Emotions. Would you like to elaborate on that? Emotions. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Sorry, 1 minute, ma'am. Stories have triggered reflections in each of us. And all of this happened without anyone standing here and telling what to think and how to think. That's the beauty of stories, because they give us opportunities for unraveling rather than for telling. You know, there's a popular saying in Africa. The grandmother says, I tickle the children, I tell them stories, and when they laugh, I put wisdom in their mouth. Stories are literally, you know, a way of packaging what we really like to, from our heart, from our mind, share with someone else. But we'd rather share it in a manner that they are listening, they are visualizing, they are imagining, they are experiencing and arriving at the truth for themselves, rather than somebody telling them. That's the deeper purpose it serves. So, one small exercise. Would you all have paper and pen with you? Would you all be having? Great. Also, yeah. Sketches also. Yeah, you would need sketches also. We'll come to that. Have a small activity. I'd request everyone to participate. And I promise we are going to do something which is interactive and group work. But the initial part needs to be only an individual exercise. Yeah? So even if you're tempted to talk about it to your neighbor, please try and resist that temptation, because then we can have an even more exciting interactive activity. Yeah? So what are we going to do? Everyone has paper? Yeah, you need like a A4 sheet or something, not a post-it. Okay, cool. Yeah, that works. The notebook size works. Lovely. Yes, sir. Could you lift it up? Yes, the one that sir is showing, that size is fine. At least that much. Bigger than that is cool, but smaller than that may be a little challenging. Everyone has something to write with? Okay. So don't worry, you don't need to write, you need to draw. So the exercise we are doing is, I'd like you to take a few moments, go flashback, okay, flashback your own life. You're going to look back. Look back at your own life and choose one memory, something that actually happened in your life. Okay, it could be when you were 3 years old, 13, 32, 50, yesterday, doesn't matter. But a very powerful memory that, you know, like now if you just recollect it, it's still alive inside you, that kind of a memory. I'd like you to recollect one such memory, happy, sad, funny, romantic, anything, it's fine, as long as you're willing to share later, yeah? Just choose that memory. Take a breath, go back into that memory, and I'd like you to use this entire sheet of paper and make a drawing of that memory. Drawing, not write. Don't write about it. How many of you can draw well? Excellent, we have one person, all the rest cannot. I need people who can't draw. Okay. Yeah? Oh, you can draw well, okay. Only one or two. No problem, if you can draw well, it's not a problem. So the rest of us, let me give you some hints, okay? You know, stick figures, cartoons, those are all ways of representing characters. And then, there are some ways, just use your mind, you'll find to represent the scene. There are just those two things. You have to represent the characters, you have to represent that scene, right? So find some way to represent the scene and to represent the characters. Make a drawing of that particular experience, okay? Don't start. Huh? Wait. Please don't start, okay? One more very important instruction, which I already gave, but I'm repeating, so you know how important it is. Please do it as an individual exercise. Okay, refrain from speaking about it to the neighbor or even peeping into your neighbor's drawing. Okay, we will be doing that. We'll get time for that. But the process is more meaningful if you just do it as an individual exercise. Any doubts about this? It's clear, the activity? Okay, your time starts now. You have 3 minutes.
No words in between.
You want to write one dialogue, you can write.
Words also in the picture.
Then don't write. No problem. Okay. That's the timer. 3 minutes up. So all those who have finished, please stand up with your drawing upside down. Nobody should be able to see it. Kisi ko dekhna nahi chahiye aapka drawing. Khali aapko dekhna chahiye. Those who have finished, please stand up. Mostly ready. What about those behind? Backbenchers. Backbenchers should enjoy this activity. So are we ready for the next step? Anyone needs time for completing their drawing? Okay, we'll give 10 seconds more for those. Picture kudu. Ready. Because I'm having a lot of faith in this group of participants, right? So would you be willing to, yeah? Great. All you have to do is, now I'll just keep making some music or some sounds or singing something. And you have to just walk around. Walk around the room holding your drawing. Just walk around. And the further you walk from your place, even better. Aapki jagah, nahi, don't show anybody, madam. Don't show anybody, just walk around. I'll give you time to show. No talking. Tandi nakkara tandari to na to no takato no tom to no takato no tom to no takato no. Walk. Keep walking. Walk. Keep walking. Okay, stop. Stop. Can you please get into groups of four? Groups of four. Any four people near you? Groups of four. Make groups of four. Groups of four. Done?
Super. Now? Now, just a minute. Groups of four done? Okay. Now you'll take turns. You will take turns making sure that every one of you, each person, gets to share their drawing and the story in their drawing. The other three people, please listen to them. One. Second, I would like you to observe how you are feeling when you are listening. And also when you tell, try to also observe how are you feeling when you are telling. Okay? So every group of four, start. Your time starts now. 2 minutes per person. 2 minutes per person. Your grandmother? It took you down your memory line. Yeah, you saw your childhood through the picture, and so did the others in your group. Yeah? Got a peek into the lives of the others in your group. Yeah. Would we agree? Did the others also see that there was so much excitement in the sharing?
Listening to a 65 years back story of the real thing what has happened, which made him a good banker now, and who has lost 5 rupees that day. This story was so interesting.
Oh. 65 years old story of losing 5 rupees and today becoming a banker. I am really interested. Yes. Oh, sad part of the story. Yeah, there was a choice to share any. Yeah.
On the sidelines, I have come to know some secret of the person which he was hiding for many years. Thanks to the story idea, now I can blackmail.
The coincidence that Mandira ji and myself, we shared the same story.
Oh.
Yeah, it was something like when I was 5 years old and I wanted to learn bicycle without the side support wheels, and my father said no, and I fell down and learned. And same thing happened with Mandira ji also. Sorry, Shashi ji. Sorry, Shashi Khurana ji. And even Jyoti ji and who was it? Glory also had more or less similar stories to
similar
share.
Stories, yeah.
I would like to say, basically, this was all filled of emotion, drama and tragedy with all the lot of behind it.
Okay.
Everybody went through that gamut of feelings over there.
Right, right.
In storytelling, actually, the more important part is story listening. When somebody says story, you have to listen. Hamare Hindi mein purane zamane mein bola jata tha ki phunka dete raho. The phunka, until unless you give phunka, jaise dadi ne bola, ek sher aaya, achha, sher, is type of, jab tak this type of explanation is not there, the interest of story cannot be maintained, okay?
We were excited to share because we knew that there's somebody to listen. You know, that's the most interesting thing about storytelling. It doesn't exist without the listener. You can just dance for yourself, you can sing for yourself, you story tell to somebody. So Dr. Brian Strum, who's been doing a lot of research in this space, he works in library sciences in Carolina University. He talks about the idea of a web, you know, that in the process of a story being told, there is a web that gets created between the teller, the story, and the listener. And this is a web of many, many different things. You know, it's a web of emotions. It's a web of trust, because the storyteller is taking you on an emotional journey. And it is the storyteller's responsibility to bring the listener back safe. The listener is agreeing to go on that emotional journey and is reassured when he or she is brought back safe. It is also a web of imagination, because together, the four of you in the group traveled to that particular person's life. With stories, we travel through time and space and come back. So it is the same as going on a picnic or an excursion or a tour with the same set of people. Yeah, there is a web of shared experience that gets created, because in your imagination, you are all together experiencing the same experience just by virtue of communicating it. There is a web of reflection. There is a web of critical thinking that happens, right? Because every story, when we are asking, kisi na kisi ke mind mein koi na koi thought aa raha hai us kahani ke bare mein. So that inevitably happens. So there are so many rich possibilities in this web. If we keep it in mind that this web exists between the teller, the story, and the audience, then there are so many things that particularly people in the communication field, particularly leaders and trainers, can do. Because what potential lies is not just in the content. The point I'm trying to make is that the content is valuable, of course, but that also the transaction itself is so valuable. The transaction of storytelling is itself so meaningful for the one who listens and for the one who tells. So just bringing in stories to start with, you know, second is the content, but just bringing in stories in our communication is itself a really powerful way of making it a meaningful engagement, one. Second, because stories do not tell and they allow for unraveling, the chances of whatever is the influence that we are hoping for, I might want a change of thought in my audience, I might want somebody to act in a certain way, I might want someone to take a certain decision, all those possibilities are higher when I just share a story and leave it for reflection. You know, like Brené Brown says, storytelling is data with a soul. So that's what differentiates it from data and statistics, which is very often what comes in, you know, usually in PowerPoints and communication, where this is this, statistics, information. information Google will give you today, right? So that is what a story can do. A story can give you information, but in the package of emotion, in the package of something that tugs at your heart. Information doesn't necessarily tug at your heart, right? Oh, do you know there are so many people who died in so-and-so place? I mean, that's information, right? But if you have a story, the actual life story of one of those people, you know, which is what you heard now, then there is a possibility of an impact on the heart and the mind, then there is a possibility of impact of action, right? This is what I was coming to whenever I'm talking about storytelling in communication. So in all my TEDx talks, wherever I've spoken to youth, my TEDx talk is full of little stories. Because the point is not to lecture an audience. The point is to tell stories and allow for thought, right? So thank you for sharing that about listening, right? So I'd like you to just think about how it felt to listen and how it felt to be listened to. You shared and three other people listened, right? So how was that feeling for you?
Thank you very much. I was